So, on a random day in Seattle, I was trying to figure out what I wanted to do. Starbucks? No. I thought Pike Place Market? Nah. So actually, the decision I made was to come to the International District and come to Chinatown. So I'm gonna go into the large market here. It's Uwajimaya Market. Sorry if I butchered that name. But we're gonna go inside right now and see everything that this market has to offer. All right, so outside of the marketplace, people are kind of hanging around. There's great, interesting decoration here. These people were dancing. And it's a beautiful weather, as you can see. I love Seattle weather. It's hot but cloudy. All right, so we're gonna go inside the market. As you can see, everybody here is wearing a mask. It's mandatory, so you can't come inside without wearing a mask. And everybody here is following the rules, so that's nice. Plus, everybody looks really awesome in their masks. Okay, what do we have here? Some sort of panda food. There's an awesome dragon watching over everything. Cute little chicken. All right, so I'm just gonna walk around for a little bit, see what everything is here. Hopefully not buy too much delicious food. Here's the candy aisle. So, let's go this way. So I think I just found the section that I'm going to be shopping from. Like, not food actually at all, but cute little trinketries from some of my favorite shows. They have so many cute things here, oh my god. On cute overload right now. Unfortunately, I'm flying home, so I don't have room in my backpack to carry this. Or all of these things. Maybe all of these things because they're tiny. Let's see. Oh, we have Hello Kitty. We have panda things. Little sushi guys. More little sushi guys. Like all the cutest stuff. Oh, and some random Seattle thing.
George 4 1 2 7 6 George 4 1 2 7 6 3 4 1 2 7 6 3 4 1 2 7 6 3 4 1 2 7 6 3 4 1 2 7 6 3 4 1 2 7 6 3 4 1 2 7 6 3 4 1 2 7 6 3 4 1 2 7 6 3 4 1 2 7 6 3 4 1 2 7 6 3 4 1 2 7 6 3 4 1 2 7 6 3 4 1 2 7 6 3 4 1 2 7 6 3 4 1 2 7 6 3 4 1 2 7 6 3 4 1 2 7 6 3 4 1 2 7 6 3 4 1 2 7 6 3 4 1 2 7 6 3 4 1 2 7 6 3 4 1 2 7 6 3 4 1 2 7 6 3 4 1 2 7 6 3 4 1 2 7 6 3 4 1 2 7 6 3 4 1 2 7 6 3 4 1 2 7 6 3 4 1 2 7 6 3 4 1 Practice social distancing, keep 6 feet of separation, and limit your shopping party to essential persons only.
So as you can see, inside the grocery store area, there are tons and tons of snacks.
Grocery department, customer service to aisle 6B. Grocery, customer service to aisle 6B, please.
And pretty much everything has something cute on it, whether it's makeup or chips or chocolate. Like everything has some cute little picture or character to represent the brand. So cuteness level here is a maximum. So they also have a pretty large section of alcohol. I don't know what some of these things are. That's a black raspberry wine. And I guess probably beer. Oh. And some Tennessee moonshine, I guess. Because why not? And then some standard alcohol over here. Super popular brand of sake is here. There's different kinds of that. And then, oh, tanuki sake. Oh, what a cute little guy. And this is a pretty large container. So if you drink all this, you'll be feeling like this guy.
Department, if you got 1210.
Okay, so I've been here one time before, and the last time I was here, this hall was bustling with people. There were tables in the middle. They were so crowded, you couldn't even find a place to sit down. This whole section was restaurants that were open, so you could get your food and then sit and eat. And while things seem a little bit normal, people are still buying food. Thai place is open, some other places are open. But you can definitely tell, like, we're still in the pandemic. Obviously, it's a little bit sad to see, because I think some of these restaurants are probably closed permanently. I think maybe all of them didn't survive, but it won't last forever. People are still coming out and shopping, and they're being safe. There's not a lot of social distancing, but definitely everybody's still wearing their masks, and you can't sit and eat here, so obviously that's a good thing. So you can still order food. Here's the opposite corner of the grocery store entrance, and as you can see, it's still all part of the international district, and as if the grocery store didn't have enough cute things inside, attached to the grocery store is Kinokuniya bookstore. So we're gonna go inside and see what's cute in here, which you can see without even going in yet. These cute little mask sign. Please use your mask.
Thank you.
So I walk next door from the bookstore to Boba Cafe. As you can see, the bookstore is just right over there. Having boba is a great excuse to be able to take my mask off. It's a little stifling. It's a little humid here. I'm sweating a little bit, but as you can see, also because of COVID, there are social distancing rules in place. Here's a look around the cafe. So, just gonna sit here for a few minutes and then see what to do next. Maybe go get something to eat or buy some groceries. I don't know, but I love it here. If you ever get a chance to come here, I highly recommend coming here. So I'm back in my Airbnb, and I have to say that going to the International District was definitely worth my time, And if you get a chance, you should go there too. It was established sort of as Chinatown in the late 1980s. And I saw a lot of other countries and cultures represented there. So it's called Chinatown, but it's also the International District. So you can find restaurants and shops from Thailand, Korea, Japan, Vietnam. So there's many different countries represented in a small area. So it's a really nice place to go and walk around and go and be hungry. There's a lot of delicious food. And a few things I got from the grocery store, the sriracha chocolate, and some agritsuko crackers. And I got this cute little dog mask. And finally, for breakfast, I have some really popular, it's Taiwanese, Mr. Brown black coffee in a can. So I'll be drinking that in the morning. So I hope you enjoyed this video. I enjoyed making it and going down there and eating and just walking around, seeing everybody, especially in the park when they were playing ping pong. So I've been to China a couple of times, and when I was there, I saw a lot of that activity, so it really reminded me of being in China. So come here if you get a chance. Thanks.